What's going on, guys? Steven here, and today we got the information about NHL 18 Hockey Ultimate Team. I wanted to walk you guys through the new things and the returning user bonuses. I'm going to make it pretty quick. I just want to, you know, if you're looking for the information, I just want to throw it out there. So the first thing is like the returning user bonuses. I was pretty curious about this myself. As you can see, they have these goofy ass jerseys here. Is pretty interesting. they're pretty funny looking, but all you had to do was play NHL 15, 16, or 17 in order to get these. So like me, I've played all these, you know, I have all these games, so I should get all three of these jerseys, the Bruins, Chicago, and the Blues. So that's pretty cool that they're giving these away. They're kind of funny looking. You can see, you know, what games people have played. But anyway, the other thing is you can get up to 5 returning user packs. And here are the 3 things that will determine how many you get. Of course, you'll probably only get 1 or 2 anyway because it's EA. So don't get your hopes up too much on that. But I guess we'll have to see. And then, you know, you're seeing what comes in each pack right here, and, you know, players contracts, you know, stuff like that. Apparently injuries are still in. That's great. Contracts are still in. Great. That's amazing. We all saw how great contracts went last year for when the market stopped working, when the buy now quit working. That was great. So we'll see how it works in NHL 18. But yeah, that's the returning user bonus stuff. If you were curious about it, that's how it's working. So there you go. The other thing I wanted to talk about was the challenges. And this looks interesting. This does look interesting. I like this. As you can see, there's team challenges, 3-star challenges, synergy, NHL journey, and co-op. And the team challenges, basically, I'm assuming you play a game or a season as you know, different teams throughout the varying leagues. And, you know, however, I guess you set up those leagues will determine your rewards, which is kind of cool. And then 3-star challenges work kind of like, you know, you have 3 objectives, as you can see here. And, you know, as you get all 3 of those in a game, you can get, you'll get the varying rewards, as you can see here, which is pretty cool. That's nice. It does say at one point, I believe, that you can only earn the rewards once. Yeah, no, not there. You will only get the rewards from completing a challenge once. So there, that question's answered. And also the co-op question. If you're playing co-op, the guests, only the host will receive the rewards. The guests won't receive the rewards, which I guess, you know, kind of sucks for doing co-op. You have to do everything twice. You know, that's great, but I'm assuming it's just so you don't, like, plug in an empty controller, you know what I mean? You know, just have an empty player sitting there getting the stuff, is what I'm kind of assuming they're thinking. But either way, in the end, it makes you do them twice if you're gonna do the co-op ones. And then the synergy challenges. At first, I thought this was gonna be, they were gonna do some garbage where they were like, oh, build a team with all the synergies or something like that, like, make you spend the money to get the challenge. But apparently it's challenges to earn a player item for the synergies, which is good. I thought it was going to be like the sets, you know, where you basically have to pay to do the sets. So that's good. They're not doing that, although they still have the sets. NHL Journey, embark on a journey from the Memorial Cup all the way to the NHL with your HUT team. So that's like an extended offline seasons, I would assume. Extended offline season. So something to do other than just Division 1, what I did last year, much better. Co-op challenges, invite a friend, play local. That's pretty cool. So, you know, you can have people come over and you can do that. I'd much rather do local play rather than, you know, have somebody have to do these twice. So anyway, those are the new challenges. So they also say, new rewards to earn, updated, you know, that's what they said about draft champions, but that never got updated, so we'll see. Hopefully they do. I would be very happy if they do, you know, come out with, you know, new challenges every couple months or every month even. I don't really know how many different things you could do. I can't think of it right now, but hopefully they do keep it updated. This will be a great thing. Keep the game unique, keep the game new and fresh throughout the year, because they're always releasing new cards, but there's really no incentive to play the game because you can't afford it anyway. So, you know, this will be interesting if they actually, you know, follow through with it. So That is the new stuff in NHL 18. I'm looking forward to it. I will have content on NHL 18 on the Young Stars. So three days early, I will have the game footage, you know, because I will be, you know, pre-ordering the Young Stars edition. So I will have the game 3 days prior to release. So I will have content. I appreciate you guys watching. If you have any questions or, you know, let me know your thoughts on NHL 18 Hut. What you guys are thinking, if you guys are thinking it's just bullshit anyway and you guys aren't interested in it at all, let me know what you think. Let's have a discussion. So anyway, thanks for watching the video. Hope I brought you guys some decent information. It's kind of a rant, but I will see you guys later. Thanks for watching the video. Y'all have a great day.